our concluding discussions on the project logistics. So anybody has worked out some additional figures or whatever?
Yesterday we had come up with some figure, 43,000 or something. I don't remember that. There is somebody who pointed out that in, I think, Surat or somewhere, where there are two coordinators and they are paid 6,000 rupees. Surat person is here. That is correct figure, no? So when we multiplied by 3,000 by 2, that was adequate? Or is it 6,000 to each coordinator? To each coordinator. Oh my God. So what you are saying is, I have to add 6,000 rupees more here. Kya baat hai? Okay. So we'll call it Surat solution. Bolo.
For coordinator is 6,000 rupees.
Okay.
And for teaching staff, those who are going to help in lab, 300 rupees per day. And the session is 3 hour session, not 1.5 hour. 300 per day.
Per session, you mean then?
Per day.
Because 3 hour
session. 3 hour session, so per day you can say.
And how many teachers?
I have taken 10.
No. 10 sessions. Session. So number of teachers can be decided.
Decided is up to them only.
So it is up to them.
I have taken 10, so.
So this, you are saying, this is 3,000. Okay.
And technical staff.
Yes.
100 rupees per day, and they are going to help in the sense of your lab and technical support, whatever is.
So this is for 10 days.
It's for 10 days.
And how many technical staff you are?
I am taking two.
Two.
And for that e-learning operator, they need one guy to operate and all those things. So for that, I decided 100 rupees per day. And one person only for this job. Just one figure you corrected, sir. The teaching staff, I have taken 10 guys for teaching staff.
10?
10 guys. 10 guys for 10 days. So it comes around 30,000.
10 guys for 10 days.
Yeah.
So 10 guys for each of the 10 days.
Huh. Ten guy for each.
No,
day.
If it is one per day,
no,
then
sir.
It is 300 into 10.
Ten guys
it
for 10 days.
Per day. Wow. So there could be more teachers than the participants.
Sir, it depends upon the number participants register for the course. No, suppose it is more, then we cannot predict how many people we require for
sir,
teaching
this,
and support.
This figure is for the 60 candidates.
Okay. So, will it be correct to assume that for 30 candidates, 5 teachers will do?
Yeah.
So, either 5 or 10.
5 or
so
10.
So, this could be either 30,000 or 50.
Or 50.
60 will become 2 coordinators. So, you are saying 6,000 per coordinator. So, then this should be 12,000 then. And then otherwise it should be 6,000.
Otherwise it's 6,000.
That's what you are saying. Okay. So, I will say class of 60. And class of 30, right? That is how these figures will be. Okay. So class of 30, your solution is much less. In terms of honorarium, it is 15 plus 6, 21, 23, 24,000. Okay. And class of 60, it will be...
If the coordinator is there, then it will
42,
be...
42, 44, 45,000.
45. And if one is...
Sorry?
Yeah. If one coordinator is there, then on the time, it's around 41,000 only.
No, that's okay. I like the idea of two coordinators.
Yeah.
Although, whether the number only is the decisive factor, but that's a different story. I will tell you what will happen. Most of the people may have two distinct labs physically.
The lecture may be a single hall of 60 people because it's on a VSAT base, but labs may be physically two labs. And naturally, we would expect coordinator of to actually look at those 30 people, one set, and 30 people another set. So this makes sense to me. Okay. So effectively, we are saying, is that okay, by the way? Let me ask you a harder question. If teaching staff is being paid 300 rupees per 3-hour session, the e-learning operator 100 rupees per day may be okay. But the technical staff, there would be different cadres of technical staff. Now, for example, we have here Dr. Mukta Atre, of course, is an administrative manager, but there are technical managers like Dr. Subhadra, Dr. Vijay Lakshmi. Now, Dr. Subhadra is a senior sysadmin, almost like an associate professor level person.
No, for senior sysadmin, we are going to keep in the teaching staff only. Okay. This tech staff, I am just supporting.
So nomenclature, would it not be better if we say teaching stroke senior technical staff?
Yes, sir.
Something like that? Then they will be part of this. Yeah. Okay. Because you may not find 10 teachers to actually who know programming to that extent in some colleges.
That's all of the, whoever the senior.
Fair enough. So is this agreeable that this then represents the realistic figures? Yeah.
Sir, based on yesterday's discussion, where we had something like 500 per session for a teaching staff and 250 per session for a technical staff.
Yes.
What in my opinion is generally the difference is just 50%. Whatever teaching staff has been assigned, 50% has been allotted for a technical staff.
Correct.
This is roughly, in my opinion, works out in all places.
So that is better. So it is better to put this as 150 and 150 rather than...
More than that is per session and this is per day. So there is a big difference.
Okay.
But what we worked out yesterday was both were per session based. I mean, we can quickly discuss it and finalize.
Okay, fine. So what you are saying is that there is no harm if to the technical staff we pay as much as 300 rupees, for example, which is per day. That
per
is
day,
two
oh,
sessions.
Right. Exactly.
And similarly, for this person also, we pay 300 rupees per day. Okay? Because you see, at the end of the day, it is the e-learning operator who is going to decide the quality of my reception. The whole edifice is built on that. वो 150 रुपए में रूट के घर चला गया बत्ती बंद करके आवर कोर्स विल कोलैप्स एंड देयर इज नो हार्म इन सेइंग दैट वी वैल्यू यू एज वेल इट्स नॉट रियली अ लार्ज चंक ऑफ मनी सो आई वुड टेंड टू एग्री विथ हिज ऑब्जर्वेशन इन विच केस दीज नंबर्स विल सिंपली बिकम दिस विल बिकम 3000 एंड दिस विल बिकम 6000 एंड इफ आई एड दीज टू डिफरेंसेज दिस इज 4000 डिफरेंस दिस इज 2000 डिफरेंस सो आई हैड 6 हियर and I had 6 here. So this becomes 30,000 and this becomes 51,000. Am I right? Roughly that's the calculation.
Yes.
Okay, fine. We'll take this as acceptable by everyone. Okay. Now we have to work out the other costs. The other costs are stay, food and transport. I mean travel. Now one of the important hallmark of my scheme suggested to MHRD is that today, if IIT Guwahati arranges a QIP or IST program, then maximum money is spent by the government in travel. And very little money is spent in coordination and actual activity. Here the idea is that the travel expenditure should be either zero or minimal. So consequently, anybody trying to register cross country, that is, Bombay people wanting to register in Bangalore and Coimbatore person wanting to go to Pune. Okay. Now, these are fancy flights of imagination, but we must immediately say that that is not possible. The best way to say is, I have tried the following thing, just consider this.
I just want to clarify one thing. How the registration process is going to happen? It's going to happen online, no, sir?
Yeah.
So suppose a person registered, because we have multiple campuses, suppose a person from a nearby place, near Famithapuri, registered in Coimbatore campus or Bangalore campus, so how is it be filtered?
The solution is simple. The solution is not saying that you can't do it or police it. The solution is to say not more than 1,000 rupees be paid for travel expenses both ways.
Can we restrict it that way, the nearest place where
nearest
from
place,
their college?
From where they are working.
No. There is still a larger implication. Please remember that even after this second workshop, we still do not have presence from large tracts of the country. What if somebody wants to come from Patna? The nearest center probably is Nagpur. Okay. If 20 teachers from Patna want to pile up on Kanpur, oh, Kanpur will go bankrupt with this kind of things. Nagpur, I mean. Nagpur se koi hai idhar abhi. So whatever. What I am saying is, why not we say that we shall restrict the travel reimbursement up to a maximum this amount per candidate. That is, we want to spend all our money in actually teaching learning process, making sure that the teachers and learners are well taken care of during the course. Now this suggestion IST found to be okay, MHRD also found to be okay. In practice, will it work out? My guess is that if we put this restriction, automatically people will register for the nearby center. Because somebody will have to pay for their travel. Either their college will have to pay or they will have to pay. And both are likely to be reluctant in spending money from their pockets. So how much is realistic? I was saying something like 1,000 or 2,000 per participant. Because please remember that per participant expands. So let's take a case of 30 participants. Okay. And work out per participant cost. First of all, I want an approximate estimate of food and stay per day. Per participant. We are talking about per participant cost now. Estimates. We had estimated that the food will cost anywhere between 100 to 250 rupees depending upon the place, where the costs are widely different at different places. Okay. Similarly, stay, if you have a guest house or hostel or something, then the accommodation will be less. If you have to accommodate people in hostel, your budget will, you can't sustain it. Now, here is the point I was trying to make. The bigger cities where ordinarily there is a problem for accommodation, but there is also an advantage that there are many engineering colleges in those bigger cities themselves. So they don't have to stay. Smaller places can perhaps afford a relatively cheaper accommodation and food because they would have hostels or something like that. That is the assumption. Now, you know your own colleges, what kind of facilities are possible and what kind of stay charges will be levied. For example, in our staff hostel, not the guest house kind of accommodation. Staff hostel kind of accommodation is about 50 rupees per day. So I don't know how it is in your places.
We are having guest hostels that charge 100 rupees a day.
Achha, 100 rupees per day.
Can I have a suggestion?
Yeah, please.
Now for working out this, shall we decide like for 30 participant, for stay purpose, can we calculate into 15 so that the balance will be there? Instead of not blindly multiplying it by 30.
No, no, I am calculating per participant only.
Okay.
So we can calculate for any number of people, whether it is 35, 28. I will tell you the reason. The other costs I can imagine to be fixed for 30 and 60. So if there is a small variation, instead of 30, suppose 34 people come, you can still count it as 30. If 28 people come or 25 people come, still you will require that paraphernalia. You can't reduce that number. But the per participant cost can be calculated actually per participant. So there is a merit in calculating this per participant. For a gross level estimation, we can decide to multiply it by 15 or 30 or whatever. Okay. So is it okay if we take 100 rupees per day stay, 350 per day?
Yeah, per day, sir.
But is it single occupancy or double occupancy?
Double occupancy.
So then it is 125.
Yeah, 175.
So you are saying this could range up to 175 also.
Yeah.
That's the cost. Okay. We may even say that people wanting to attend at Suratkal will have to pay from their pocket. No, that will not be good. And that's the problem is that unlike, there are many engineering colleges in that vicinity, but none within, let's say, half an hour or 45 minutes. Or there are. 1 hour, I think. Nitte was...
Half an hour, yes.
So but people can still commute every day to the workshop and go back?
For a few, half of the person. Actually, the thing is that whenever NIT Surat will put anything related to the IST workshop and all, we have a huge response. That's a very big one. So first of all, my request is to you, first you set the criteria. Mention if the person from Bangalore and whatever is, they must register with Bangalore center only.
Yeah. Of course.
Like. Otherwise, it's...
No, we have, by the way, we have full freedom to reject any registration.
Oh, okay.
What we'll do is we'll open a provisional registration.
Yeah.
We will have on the wiki, we'll create a wiki along with that website. The wiki will be accessible to all of you. And we will never ever finalize a person for a center unless the center coordinator says okay. Ultimately, you are going to be responsible, you know, for their well-being or for paying them or whatever.
Then it's fine, sir.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, then you will try to target our nearby colleges.
In fact, that was the whole idea in this distributed concept. Otherwise, there is no point. We have been conducting QIPIST workshop for ages. So have you been, many of you. The point here is that a single coordinator workshop, I want 200 centers in the country in the next 1.5 years. Because from 200 centers, people literally can travel on a scooter or rickshaw or something like that and go there every morning. But doesn't matter. For the time being, we'll assume that. So what is the worst case and the best case, this thing? If I take these two extreme, the per participant cost is either 200 rupees or 425 rupees. That's a lot of cost. I am thankful for the suggestion that instead of 15 days, we do it only for 10 days. But even when you say 10 days, people will come the previous evening and people will go the next day morning. So you'll have to calculate this as 11 days figure. No, so 11 days you have to calculate anyway. It still means that it is 2,200 per participant or 2,200. Is that correct? Something like this. Now you will understand why I am saying I restrict the travel expense. Rather than paying 3,000 rupees to a person for travel, I would give him better food by spending that money here. I would give him a better accommodation here. Yeah.
Sir, as referred by madam and some of the participants, it is better to calculate for 12 days. So something like half day or this side or that side.
No, no, I have added this here. On the higher side. Okay. The problem is that the bureaucracy in Delhi does not recognize differences in location, differences in cost. Oh, we have a kahavat in Hindi, Madhya Pradesh called sab ghode bara takke. So whatever, it doesn't matter, there is no distinction, ghoda gada sab barabar. So like that, Bombay is supposed to be as cheap as Jharsuguda. Now we can't help it. So Jharsuguda people might be staying in a nice place and eating well. In Bombay, for the same money, you can either eat well and sleep on the footpath or stay in the guest house and attend workshop hungry. These are the two choices you have. Both are very bad choices. So, the worst case, we can tell them that not only no accommodation will be given, please bring your tiffin when you come to the workshop. So, we'll have a joint. Whatever. Now, the IST and MHRD is going to ask me to average this out. It will not permit us to distinguish between different centers. Or should we say, just like they have this, what you call city compensatory allowance. Anyone of you have it? There's a government mechanism has it. So they divide the cities in class A, class B, class C. Now, just as city compensatory allowance is different, or the daily allowance is different at these three places, should we be willing to say that there will be three categories or two categories depending upon the place? My Amravati friend may not be very happy. Because his cost may not be significantly lower, but he ends up getting less money for doing the same godagiri. Please observe that we are talking only about the actual cost. As far as the honorarium and all concerned, there is no city-based distinction. So is that reasonable to say that we will have these classes? Now quickly, if you take a roll call here, what are the categories of the city? which, how many of you can say do it something in this cost, how many of you will require this, and how many of you can do something in between, let's say 3500? Just I'm tentatively asking based on your own past experience of organizing. B. So one. Sorry? C. Suratkal, if you go by the Government of India classification, is probably class C.
Excuse me, sir.
Huh? So B means here.
Excuse me, sir. Here, this food includes lunch and dinner both or one-time food?
If they are staying there, okay, then depends. I mean, I don't know. It's all up to us to frame the rules. Because the point is that when they stay there,
then I think 100 rupees is not enough for both the time.
Correct.
Breakfast also includes.
Yeah, so breakfast, lunch, dinner will be not 100 rupees. How much it will be?
Maybe 250.
So 250 is the correct this thing.
Yeah, for.
But the stay may be different. So you are saying that this figure is all wrong.
Yes.
Okay. Now, if we make this as, let's say 250, then 150 rupees increase here. 150 into 11 days, this figure is perhaps closer to that. So can we say that we are talking only about either this or this?
Yes.
Okay. Let us multiply this by number of number of participants and find out what happens. I will take a round figure of 5,000 rupees instead of 5,100 that we had elaborately calculated. And if I have 30 participants, this works out to 1,50,000. Okay, for 30 participants. Okay. Now, we had worked out the total cost for 30 students as 30,000 rupees. So for 30 participants, 1,80,000 is the cost of stay, food and other things. If I have to add to it a maximum amount of travel that I will reimburse, which is the condition that we will put, that this is the maximum amount of travel. We are not saying you cannot come from any place. You come from whatever place, preferably from a nearby place, but the course will not be able to compensate you for more than this much amount for travel. Now, if people are traveling within about 100 kilometers of your place, or say 50 to 100 kilometers, what will be the travel cost typically? No. You take that if they are daily travel, then you save on food and stay. Then you can give him a rented car every day. It's not a problem. Ultimately, you have to balance the financial thing there. But assuming that they come and stay with you and they are within 100 kilometers, 100 kilometer travel by either bus, train, whatever the entitlement, maximum 200. What I was suggesting is, suppose I say max limit on travel reimbursement. Is rupees 1,000 both ways. Now this 1,000 you can use it for local travel for 10 days, or this 1,000 you can use it for coming and staying with us. If we do that and multiply with this by 30, we actually can run this course in 2,10,000 rupees. What about the institutional overhead?
So small addition is,
yes,
maybe with respect to that list of members, yes, maybe that is a small addition. One attender we were talking yesterday,
yes,
and miscellaneous expenses like many things like materials, or and as you pointed out, the institution resource usage.
So any suggestion on the miscellaneous expenses, because these will be gross amounts, right?
Institute charges typically, like Government of Maharashtra pays for MSCIT exams and others, it is like 25 rupees into number of students into number of days. 25 into 30 into 10. That is the institute facility utilization charges.
7,500.
Yeah.
That is your Maharashtra government.
Yeah, Maharashtra.
Suppose we say 10,000 rupees lump sum.
Okay.
Will that be okay? This goes directly to the institute for whatever purposes the director wants to use it.
And diesel charges are like for generators, like different colleges in Maharashtra typically for load shedding.
The generator is going to be a major thing. I have to get a clearance from Delhi on that. I had talked to somebody and he suggested that you put it under consumable budget. But what he finally said is you can spend from consumable budget, but you have to manage the total thing in the budget that we have given. So it is like I have to basically take out his shirt and give it to you to burn diesel. There is no other choice I have. The total budget will be fixed. I am trying to negotiate that total budget. That is why I want it. So suppose we put this as 10,000. Just rough estimate on miscellaneous expenditure.
Something like per participant we can fix an amount multiplied by that. 100 into 30.
100 into 30. No, this will be one time. It's not per day.
No, one. It is easy time. To.
No, it's not a daily miscellaneous. No, this is like you give them handouts. Xerox and give them handouts or whatever. So something like 100 rupees per participant. So 30 into 100 is let's say 3000 rupees. But I would like to break this miscellaneous expenditure into two kinds. One is actually whatever you may say material like Xerox or certificates or whatever. So I will like to put that as say 5000. I would like to put that additional 5,000 as contingency available to the coordinator. Suppose you have to hire somebody, run there and do something. Now, you should be financially independent. What happens otherwise is that, and if you are able to compensate somebody, people will be eager to work. So if they know you are a Fokanda man, then they will not much care for you. That's a fact of life, you know. I mean, you should have a financial stature. Say, I'm bolega to, I will compensate you. Now, if we add all of these, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000, this becomes 2,30,000. What IST is telling me is that they will no way agree for more than 1,85,000 or something. I have been questioning their figure. Actually, I have been fighting to get 2,50,000. What the government has approved me is 2,00,000 rupees. So the maramari is going on this. This is the IST figure. This is what I have demanded. This is DB Phatak's figure. And this is MHRD's current figure. Now, if you look at this figure, it is 30,000 rupees less. I would rather reduce this maximum limit on travel expenditure, which made 30,000. To 15,000, but not reduce these. Because the contingency in the hands of coordinator is according to me the most important component, where the coordinator feels very comfortable doing small things. Yeah. Yes, any suggestion in this?
Sir, although I don't have experience about this finance, but I feel institute charges of 10,000, considering like 3-4 labs will run for 10 days with AC and power consumption and all these things. I don't know whether maybe the people who have hosted will...
In my institute, I have been slogging for this for 2.5 years. You saw the staff. All of them are being paid salary from the MHRD funds. The institute overhead being paid is 0 rupees. This is a national mission. And if any institution in the country has received direct or indirect support from MHRD, actually this will be questioned grossly.
Okay. Yeah, that's
a fact of life. Ministry along with the CVC and the auditors, etc., will descend on your campus, ask you to return whatever doles you got from government. Now, the fact of life is that there are many private institutions who have to spend some money. What I would like to suggest is that, and I will write this letter to heads of the institutions.
Yeah,
saying that please consider this to be a national mission. Okay. As a part of the, it is called national mission. And the purpose is to train teachers better so that the students get trained better. So that all of us in our postgraduate courses, we get better students. But overheads of anything, IIT Bombay gets 0 rupees overheads, zero. And as an added attraction, it continues to pay my salary. So that's, but of course, so the colleges like Suratkal and all, for example, I mean, I'm not sure what exactly Sanchati will answer to ministry when we show 10,000 rupees as overhead. Yes. I am saying that I would like to include it because I will not put it as institute charges. I will say charges for institute facilities used, something like that. The facilities, whatever. But I would think that just like my coordinator should have a 5,000 rupees of contingency, the director of the institute should also have 10,000 rupees to spend. Some, you see, when you conduct this course, there will be several people who will say, wonderful work you are doing. There will be several others saying, are institute ka kaam chhodke ye kar raha hai. To tell them, the director should be able to say, look, he is also earning a little money for the institute. So this is token. I think we should take it like that, token. Is that okay?
Like even if you don't pay the institute charges, it's okay, but the diesel charges are important. Institutes won't be ready to run the facilities by generator sets because that is a big amount, typically in our case.
You should collect that money from the energy minister of Maharashtra state. But I will tell you what you have to do in that case. What I propose also I will tell you. I will fight for 2,30,000 rupees. I will fight for 2,35,000 and I will fight hard. And I can assure you, wherever I have fought hard in life, I have not lost. So I should be able to get this. If I get this for 30 people, then I think we should be okay. Okay. Now, within these 2,30,000, if you can cut the cost here and there and arrange for it, I think that should be fine. So in your case, for example, all of these 10,000, all of your contingency, and you can give only lunch and not dinner, so you'll get some, save some money. You can ask the participants, do they want light in the class or they want food in the stomach? You have one of the two choices.
The budget, one thing we, yesterday evening we were discussing, we were talking about the, I mean, enthusiasm within, I mean, from different teachers, with yes. respect to as soon as they see the brochure.
Correct, correct.
My feel or some of our feel is, can we add something like OS technology or open source, something, that kind of term in the title of our workshop, which will enhance the interest towards the workshop.
I see. Instead you of still believe that just by writing programming, people may not be interested.
Yes. So will it be appropriate to add that term?
I have absolutely no problem. We can say using state of art technologies and open source or something of that. Well, since we are creative, I would suggest all of you over the next 4 or 5 days in your travel back, in your flight, car, taxi, whatever, please keep thinking about it and please keep sending emails back. Yeah, sorry, you have some suggestion?
Regarding the infrastructure they are using in the lab, please we have to make sure each machine it installed in some Linux distribution.
Yes.
It is not using PuTTY or any hyper terminal.
No.
Please make sure to install the...
No, in fact, but that's the whole point of yes. exposing you to these installations.
Correct. In our institution we will take care. Yes. This is a convey to our staff.
That is why these installations can be dual boot, so you don't disturb any... If you have a Microsoft setup, many colleges may have a Microsoft setup. But you will not disturb it. But you will have to dedicate one server, which is an NFS mount server. That server will have to have large space. That can also be dual mount. But for the lab, you have to run it like a Linux server. And when you say the lab, for the entire workshop, because people staying there will be accessing it at any point in time. And the idea is to encourage people to access it in the night or in the evenings or whatever. So that server has to be more or less full-time working. And the machines, you can at best have dual boots. But all our environment, for example, when the CS101 course starts, 4 sysadmins, which are MTech students, will go and install Linux on all 100 machines. So they will ask the teacher, what environment do you want? We had never been able to do it so well as we are doing it for the course, by the way. We are making DVDs which will directly can be used. They contain all the resources. Today, our sysadmins have to find out this resource from here, this resource from there, this resource from there. So that will have to be done. There's no shortcut for that. Now, that's the second thing I wanted to tell you, is that lab environment will decide how many people can you actually have. Now, here is my suggestion. If I can make 45 people or 40 people instead of 30, okay, or say even 60 people, then the cost is less than two times this.
It has been added, sir.
We added this 30,000 rupees.
Only that 30,000 is not going to make a difference.
Now this 30,000 will become 51,000 for 60 people.
Yes.
And this number will also increase. Okay, anyway, whatever, I think I will fight for 2,30,000. But the idea is that I would like to have a flexibility from MHRD saying that depending upon the number of registrations, we would like to give varied grant, not a fixed grant as IST does. So there what we will do is, we will compute miscellaneous expenses, institute charges, and this amount as fixed, depending upon the slab. And the variable, whatever we have calculated, we'll calculate on a per participant basis, rounded up to the nearest integer or some such thing. Means we can't do multiple computations. Secondly, the modus operandi. Since money will not come from IST or MHRD, money will come from IIT Bombay. Because MHRD is giving us the money. We had told them that we do not want any bureaucracy in delay of payment and so on. And we would be able to pay you in advance. Now, whether we should pay you the entire amount in advance, after which you may have to return some money if the participants are less, or we should pay you an estimated total amount we make, 50% we pay immediately, and 50% by the, when the registrations are over, when the last date of registration is over, the remaining 50% or whatever we calculate, we send a money. Is that all right? So 50% of the money we can send as early as within the next month, for example. Only thing is, don't spend it before the workshop starts. Otherwise, usko khana nahi milega udhar. No, because the freedom, financial freedom that we enjoy as project investigators is total. I have, for example, the same authority, financial authority, as a head of the department has, as far as spending money from the project is concerned. I don't think that situation is same everywhere. There would be governance structure. So I am not worried about the money getting spent. In fact, you will have problems in spending that money quickly, getting so many approvals. Is it okay to insist on some utilization certificate back from you? Just as we have to give a utilization certificate, we should get a utilization certificate saying that the total expenditure for this was this, or this money was utilized. I want to make this simple, because we calculate, you know, that per person basis, so 37 rupees 50 paise you have to return me. So that transaction will cost 500 rupees. It's not worth it. Besides, why should I be wanting that money back? I have convinced the government to give me, let's say, 2,30,000. I don't need it here. So I might as well give it. But I will need utilization properly. Can I assume that internally all expenditure that you do is properly audited and so on? It is. So that's okay. So we will not insist on audited accounts. I have to yet clarify this. MHRD was saying you must get audited account from everybody. Now, audited account from everybody will be a mess for us, you know. From 30 people audited accounts and then plus minus this, that, we don't know how to handle it. What is the normal practice for IST? When IST gives you money, does it ever ask for detailed account?
Yes, sir.
They ask for accounts, is it?
Yes.
Achha, that is why he was shouting at me. I see.
Sir, actually, based on that workshop whichever we conduct, be it 5 days or 10 days, a separate bank account is normally opened. Money is put there so that it becomes something like legal or open to everyone.
And what do you do?
Then we submit a full detailed something
like that.
But
what happens to the remaining balance money?
Balance money, generally it is returned.
It is returned.
Done, but
if it is funded,
he doesn't return it.
No, no.
Dominic doesn't believe in returning money.
No, no.
I like that.
No, I would also agree that every institution sees that the account comes to the.
Generally, the institution will ensure that before sending the account, all money is spent. For that part, like a dinner party for all the teachers. No, that is okay.
Sir, coming back to the brochure and all what you are talking about, that one I am having a little bit problem there. As I have discussed with the Mumbai University syllabus, it is more focused on C++. And when we are telling that it is computer programming and wherein…
We are not saying that. We are saying effective teaching learning of computer programming. Now, computer programming is also Java programming, is also SQL programming.
So, nowhere it will be mentioned that what language it is.
We will have to
mention
it, but the details will be on the website when we describe the detailed program. That detailed program we will describe only after the registration date closes. After the registration date closes, we might also extend it further in case some centers do not have sufficient registrations or whatever. Okay. You see, the point is, my ambition is to run this pilot for 1,000 teachers. And that's the reason why I'm suggesting that some of you who can, who have large institutions and large infrastructure, if you can enthuse some other colleague to also add to yourself as a coordinator and have enough paraphernalia to run for 60 people, absolutely no issue, but more the merrier. I had originally thought that there will be one teacher for programming per college, and I had thought totally there are 3,000 teachers in the country. I was grossly wrong. The number is 10 times more, 15 times more. So we need to do this anyway. And I will tell you something. If we can do it for 1,000 teachers, and if that workshop succeeds, the government is going to open the tap for additional 10, 15 courses. So next time, when we do the subsequent course, which is C++ object, for your benefit, we'll say object-oriented programming in the title. So you will not, your thing will not.
Excuse me, sir. Can we invite the polytechnic lecturers, those are teaching the diploma institutes? Because even the diploma in computer and IT.
As I said, in a ordinary college, if there is a BSc IT or BSc computer science, and if somebody is teaching programming there, I don't see how it is different to teach programming there and programming here. Okay. Because after 12th standard, some people are coming here, some people are going there, some people are going to diploma. I don't see any significant difference in their intellectual capability. The difference is only the measurement capability of ours. Marks are different. As long as the word science is there. Science or technology or management. These three names are, personally, you see, I will tell you this. Suppose there is a teacher who actually is teaching programming part-time in some college, but he is a school teacher. Why should he be denied this opportunity to learn? What we want to involve is teachers. Any variety of teachers who are interested in effective teaching learning of computer program. But this is my personal opinion. It is not weighted administratively by the management. But then I always hold funny opinions which nobody likes. So I will put it this way. Please suggest the wordings to classify people who are eligible. We are going to insist that whatever are the wordings, if they are satisfied, because that is what legally we are required to do. However, if you have any additional suggestions, what we'll do is, in exceptional cases, we need a confirmation from the coordinators of the center that they have verified the antecedents and this is okay. And this is good enough for us.
Sir, one point that institutional participant, means the faculty who are teaching in the same institute, we have some limitation for that, means number of participants in that, so that we can give more chance to other participants. They are coming from other college.
I will tell you your problem is solved like this. If you are going to have 10 teachers participating in conducting the course, then they cannot also be attending, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you either teach or you are, in IIT Bombay, to guide a PhD student, you don't have to have a PhD. The rule is you should not yourself be registered for a PhD. I think that should be adequate. But personally, I will not agree entirely with you. Why should I say ghar ki murgi dal barabar? After all, my colleagues, if they think that they can benefit, they should also be encouraged.
Yes.
The discretion should be left to the central court. In principle, I agree with him that maximum chance should be given to other places. You see, we should always remember that we represent some of the better institutions in the country. And it is our job to go out and serve the other people. So to the extent that we are able
to do, sir, one thing that is that in register.
You can, by the way, you can do one thing. You can permit additional people what we call sit through. So they will not get certificate, but they can sit through the course. And as a matter of fact, if there are your own faculty members who eat at their homes, who don't stay in your facility, and who use a computer which they will ordinarily do, what is the expense you have for them? As long as the expense is zero, you say these are 60 people who are costed as per this. There are 10 additional people from my college who are attending this. No issue.
Okay, sir.
The government is worried about money spending. Government is, in fact, interested if all teachers like that only attend. Yeah. No, they will not be counted towards this. The local staff will not be counted towards the numbers according to which this budget is computed. Yes, very much so. You can issue them. This is a good point that you have made. Thanks for bringing this out. What we'll do is, we'll definitely say that, we'll say this to you only. They need not know. So if they want to register, they should understand that they will not be paid TADA. They will not be entitled for any accommodation that others are. So if, as it is, they are staying outside and travelling every day to the college, they should continue to do so. They must not cost anything to the project, but they will have the privilege of attending and getting a certificate.
Sir, in registration we put another field that you are in the same college or not. So that will be very better clear to the you also and the coordinator also.
She can make suggestions for brochure, suggestion for what clauses we should try and include, and any other suggestions for costing variations that you can think of. But I think we can conclude here that 2,30,000 seems to be okay for conducting this workshop for 30 people. Okay. And we will say if there are 60 people, the cost will be 4,60,000. But there have to be 60 plus, that is the point. If there are less, then that doubling the amount will have a problem. So 30 people, 2,30,000. Hariharan is going to shout at me because his figure for 1,85,000 is for 35 participants.
Numbers are totally different.
Huh?
These numbers are significantly different anyway.
No. What I finally told him, I said, you are not paying me the money, so why are you bothered? See, if I go to IST, then I have to follow his rules. He's not paying me. So I'll pay whatever money I have. No, he's a nice guy, but he has to follow the. I have requested him to revisit all those figures. So he said, sir, we have very recently worked them up again. So I said, very recently means when? About 4 years ago. Before that, when did you do the last review? 10 years ago. Now, this is their notion of recent. The time is eternal in India.